Hi, I'm Patti Paige, the owner of Baked Ideas, a cookie decorating company in New York City. I am going to show you how to make and decorate beautiful cookies, how to line the cookies with royal icing, how to flood them beautifully and smoothly, and how to decorate them. We're going to use a heart cookie today because it's one of my favorite cutters. It's a really easy shape. A lot of people have it around the house. You can make so many different designs with one cutter. So let's get started. Good Housekeeping TV. Genius ideas made easy. Here's what we're gonna need to do it. We're gonna need food coloring, and we're gonna need brushes to put on the icing. We're gonna need confectioner's sugar to make the icing, and a damp cloth to cover the icing when we make it so it doesn't get hard and crunchy and crusty. We're gonna need a handheld mixer to beat up the icing, and some bowls to put the icing in and mix it with food coloring, a scissor to cut the bags that we're gonna use to hold the icing, tips, size 1 and size 1.5, toothpicks to sometimes add little tiny drops of color, and some spoons to mix the icing in the bowls. Of course, some heart cookies. I chose hearts because they're really simple. Many people have a heart cutter at home and you can do so many things with them. And some egg whites to dilute the confectioner's sugar and turn it into icing, and a couple of spatulas to scoop out the icing. So let's get started. We're gonna make the icing now. And we've got in this bowl 5.5 cups of sifted confectioner's sugar, and we're going to add 7 tablespoons of egg whites. And then we're gonna stir it up and beat it up. So here I'm gonna pour in the egg whites. And I'm just gonna stir it up so that when we go to mix it with the hand mixer, sugar doesn't go flying. And I'm gonna use a hand mixer today, but you could also use a stand mixer if you've got one. So let's get it sort of all moistened here. This confectioner's sugar has been pre-sifted, but you wanna sift your confectioner's sugar always when you're decorating cookies, because any little lumps and bumps in the icing will make it difficult for you to get the icing through the little pastry tube tip, and that's a drag because then you've got to start over. So, all right, we've got this pretty moistened and nice and stiff. So I'm gonna just get this back in there. So this looks good. I think we're gonna need a little bit more egg whites. We like to keep the icing thick so that you can dilute it with food coloring, but you can tell if it's a little dry, and just add a tiny bit of egg whites as needed. So let's add a little more egg whites. And we're just gonna pour in a little bit, maybe a tablespoon, and give it another go. Okay, so you wanna see if any soft peaks have formed. So we've got very stiff peaks at this time. So we're gonna give it a little more egg whites. And what's in here? Okay. Okay. So this is nice and stiff. And what's great about having it stiff is if when you add the food coloring, it actually dilutes the royal icing. So if you start with it nice and stiff, you can make deep colors without diluting your icing, and then when you need to dilute it for flooding, you can go ahead and add more egg whites. So the main thing about confectioner's sugar is the consistency. So I'm gonna show you how to do piping consistency and flooding consistency. And I'm gonna take a spatula and scrape the sides down, because any little bits of icing that sit up on the sides of the bowls are gonna dry out much more quickly than the bulk of the stuff that's all together. So I'd like to keep it all down at the bottom of the bowl. So now I'm just gonna take a damp cloth. Super important to cover it with a damp cloth. Even if you cover it with saran wrap, it's not good enough. You need to keep moisture in the icing. Otherwise, you'll get crunchies everywhere and your icing will be really difficult to work with, okay? And we made a bunch of heart cookies. So we're going to start by decorating it to look just like what it is, a heart. So we're going to make it pink today. So I'm going to take a little bit of the royal icing and take a big spoonful, put it in this bowl, great bowl for mixing. I'm going to take a little more because we're also going to use it for flooding. And make sure, again, you always keep this covered, super crucial. So I'm going to take a little bit of pink food coloring and put, there are a few pinks out there. We'll see what this one does. Put a few drops of pink in and give it a good stir. It's stiff. And again, I want it stiff because I'm going to be using it for piping a line. So that's making a really pretty color. I oftentimes love to add a drop of white to color because I feel like it gives it a certain kind of opacity. It makes it a little opaque and it gives it a really good quality of color. So I'm going to put one little drop of white in just for the heck of it. I pretty much put white in almost everything. Not enough to lighten it, but just enough to give it a nice opaque feel. All right, so you make sure you scoop down to the bottom of the bowl, get all the white out, just give it a good stir. So now it's really great. This would be the perfect consistency if I was actually going to write words on the cookie or something, but we need it to be a little thinner now to make the flooding line. I'm going to add a little bit of egg whites to thin this out just a touch. So I'm just going to go little by little. I don't want to go too far because then it'll be too loose. And you don't need much. You want to get icing that's kind of the consistency. I sometimes think of it as toothpaste because consistency is the most important thing when you're working with royal icing and cookies. I'm going to do it a little thinner. When I'm stirring, I'm always going up the sides because if you just leave that thin icing up on the sides and just deal with what's at the bottom, your icing will, the stuff that's up on the sides is going to dry out and get crunchy. And then you won't be able to use the icing that's in the bowl. So there we go. I think that's going to be good. I go slowly because you don't want to go too far. That feels perfect. Okay. Now we're going to load up a pastry tube. This is a disposable plastic tube. I've cut a little bit, half an inch off the bottom. And I'm going to get I can use a number 1.5 or a number 1 tip. I'm going to use a 1.5. It's a little easier because it's a little bigger of a hole. And we're going to put that tip in and just pull it so it's snug there so icing doesn't come seeping through. I'm going to fold it over here so I make sure I have enough to fold it back up and hold it once there's icing in it. Now I'm just going to put this down one sec while I get some icing on a spoon. And aim and get a bunch of icing in there. Now I'm going to uncuff it and roll it down. You'll gradually be pushing the icing down towards the tip. And pull this snug again. I like to test it out to make sure it's coming out. It's coming out nice. You can see how it's just flowing out the tip. And then I'm just going to cover this, take some saran wrap and cover that bowl of icing because we'll use it later to flood the cookie. Put that aside. So I'm going to take the cookie and I'm going to pipe a line around the edge, and that line's going to hold in the icing when we flood it later. So I like to steady my hand on the counter and I hold it with my grip like this. You can also take a rubber band and tie this if you don't feel confident that you'll be able to hold it shut, but I'm just gonna grab it with my fist and with my thumb and the pressure from my other fingers, I'm gonna get the icing to flow out the tip. So when you start, you always touch down because otherwise the icing will just be hanging in midair. So you touch down to secure the icing to the cookie and then you just watch the edge of the cookie and you gradually go around the cookie. And then when I want to let go, I touch down again. The most important thing is to squeeze. It's a combination of how fast you're going and how hard you're squeezing. So if you, for instance, go too fast, your icing's going to break. If you go too close to the cookie, you can get like a wiggly line. See how that's different from that super smooth line that I had at first? The best thing to do is you touch down, attach it, and then let it fall. Way easier than it looks. It feels like, how's that line of icing ever gonna hang in midair like that? But it does. It's kind of really cool. And then to let go, you touch down again. When you touch down to let go, what you're doing is releasing your pressure before you lift your tip off. I'm gonna fix that. Before you lift your tip up, you wanna squeeze, stop, release your pressure, and then let go. So that's the cookie lined with royal icing. And now we're gonna fill it in. It's also called flooding. We just call it filling it in, but yeah, we're gonna flood the cookie. So you're gonna wanna take your icing now and thin it out to flooding consistency. So I'm gonna take a little more egg white and stir the egg white in. I mean, consistency is something that you like deal with every day, you know, a million times a day, or I do, because you're always wondering, is it too thick? Is it too thin? It's a bit of trial and error, but once you get comfortable with it, you recognize it. So you see it's kind of falling off the spoon. I'd say it's a tiny bit thick. I'm gonna give it a little bit more egg whites, but not a lot, because if you go too far, then it's super runny. Okay, I think I like this. There's a little bit of play with this. You can make it, if you make it a little bit too thick, then you have to add more, so, you know, and the weight of it will make it settle down. If you make it too thin, you can just spread it out thin and have a little less icing on your cookie. Actually, I'm gonna do touch more. Okay. So one thing I do that's different from a lot of cookie decorators is I like to apply the icing with a brush. It's still flooding, but I like to use a brush because, I'll show you. So you lift your cookie, and I'm gonna grab, these are my favorite brushes. I like a brush that's kind of stiff. The reason being, I'm not really painting as much as I am pushing the icing around. So I'm gonna dip my brush into the icing and kind of twirl it to stop the dripping. And then I'm gonna lay some on the cookie. And I'm gonna try to do that as many times as I think I might need to flood the cookie. And this is something that, you know, you kind of learn by experience. I'm gonna stop there, even though it's probably not quite enough. So you take basically the side of your brush. We call it painting, but it's really not. It's really more like pushing. You're never touching the surface of the cookie like that. You're basically just taking the side of the brush and pushing the icing around. And you see the border that we just piped on makes it so easy. It just holds the icing in for you. And I'm kind of getting a whole area. I'm not spreading it thin and then going back and adding more. I'm just getting one whole area at a time. And I think before I go any farther, I'm just gonna grab a little more. You can always take some off if you get too much. And it's kind of magically just, you know, covers the cookie. And the other thing I'm doing is while I'm doing it, I'm kind of just naturally making an attempt to cover the outer line because I just don't want to see that outer line when I'm done. I want it to look like it's all just one sort of, you know, seamless layer of pink. So that's pretty good. You can see it's kind of settling out. If my icing had been a little too thick, it would be, you know, kind of bumpy, but it seems pretty good. Let me just put it down and take a look. If you see there's spots that aren't spreading out, you can just thin them out. But you can see how smooth that is. And that's something that a lot of people ask me. How do you get your icing so smooth? And it's just easy when you use this technique. It works out great. If you see any air bubbles that bother you, you can pop them. But I just don't usually bother. I don't mind it. And that cookie's flooded and finished, and we're going to let it dry for at least an hour to do just play around with it. If I was really doing it with a specific design in mind and I wanted the surface to be super hard, I would let it go, you know, 6 hours or preferably overnight till it's really, really rock hard. and dry, and then you have a lot, gives you a lot more options of things to do with the cookie. Okay, so now our cookie is nice and dry. I think we'll give it a little decoration. We'll keep it simple. We're gonna make a little bit of white icing. So we're just gonna take a little bit of the royal icing that we made before. And we're not gonna need too much. Cover it back up. And put a little egg white in because we're gonna now get it similar to the consistency that we used to do the outline, the pink outline. Not runny like the flooding icing, but just stiff enough to hold its shape and go easily through the piping bag. So still a little stiff, but I'm not gonna add more egg whites because I wanna brighten it up a little. Because, you know, the icing without any color can tend to be a tiny bit yellowish. So we're gonna use white food coloring, which is great, because it makes the icing look really clean and fresh. I'm just gonna add a few dots and stir it in. Again, you wanna be sure to scoop from the bottom and keep the sides clear. The other thing I do try is you notice I'm not like going crazy with the stirring, I'm just kind of stirring and keeping, mashing it against the side of the bowl because you don't wanna get extra air bubbles in the icing. So let's see, I'm gonna add a touch more whitener. And teeniest bit more egg whites. It's really just a feel. You get a feel for what you want. But just think of how it'll be flowing through that little tiny piping tip hole. Okay, that looks pretty good. It's not really flowing off the spoon like the flooding icing. Looks like it'll be perfect. This is the one that's a little bit like toothpaste. Okay, so let's take another piping bag. We've cut the tip off. And I think I'll again take a 1.5 because I'm gonna put some little dots and make little flowers out of little dots. Keep it simple and pretty. And so again, get the tip snug down there, make the little cuff. And I'm gonna put that down while I grab some of the icing. Get it right down in the bottom of the bag. And I'm using my finger to kind of smush it off the spoon. Undo the cuff, fold it in on itself, and then roll it down a little bit, get the icing towards the tip. I'm gonna test it out to make sure there's no clogs and it looks good. So I think I'm just gonna make a pretty delicate little design on this. Hearts are great because they're very open-ended. You can do dots, lines, you know, frilly borders. You can do so many different things. You can make everyone totally different. But I'm gonna try this little flower design made just with dots. I'm gonna put a larger dot in the center and then some smaller little dots going around it. And the trick to making dots, and there is a little trick to it, is just to put the tip of your pastry tube tip against the surface and squeeze it out till you've formed a dot. And then lift it up, stop the pressure on the bag before you lift your tip up. If you lift your tip up while you're still squeezing, you'll bring a little string of icing up and maybe mess up your design. So I'm gonna keep going with that design, just kind of placing them wherever they look good. And you could do this in any color. I really just like the pink is so bright that the white looks just pretty with it. And it becomes just a really nice overall pattern, like a textile design almost, or wallpaper pattern. And sometimes I like to actually have it look like it's going off the edge. I'll make a few little dots here as if that's one of them, but you're not seeing the whole thing. And this is a nice design you could use for so many occasions, a baby shower, Mother's Day, just, you know, to give to a friend because it just could be for anyone. And it's really all about how hard you're squeezing, you know, to get the design, to get the size dots you want. Of course, quicker and less pressure for the smaller dots, and for the big one, stay in the spot longer and more pressure. Yeah, I think that looks great. Just even it off with one more down here. That looks great and is not really very hard. I've showed you how to line the cookie and flood it and decorate it with a few simple techniques. And now we're going to take those same techniques and use them to do a slightly more complicated cookie, but using the same shape. Now we're going to use the same techniques to make something a little more intricate. We're going to take the heart and turn it into a strawberry. So first thing we're going to do is make some red icing for the strawberry. We're going to take a little bit of royal icing, get in our bowl, just about the same amount we did for the pink heart. Cover it back up always. So you take a spoon, add a little bit of egg white to get it to the right consistency for lining, which is again that one that's a little bit like toothpaste. The consistency is basically all you really need to know about to make great cookies. Okay, so we'll add a little red food coloring. Stir it in. You always want to add the food coloring slowly because some colors get dark in a second, like black is really, you want to go just by the toothpick. And other colors, it takes a while to get the color you want. So red's kind of in between. I don't want to make it too dark because I don't think of a strawberry as a super dark red, but, and red sometimes darkens. Some of the colors darken as they sit, especially the darker colors, like blue darkens, red can darken. We'll go a teeny tiny bit more. Little drop, okay. All right, this is gonna be good. Okay, I think this is good. Take one of the bags again, make the cuff. Take a 1.5, these are my favorite tips. These are called PME tips. They are really nice because they're made in one piece. They don't have a seam down the side, so when you squeeze and icing through them, it comes out nice and straight. It doesn't have this horrible tendency to curl. And they're just really beautiful tips. Okay, so take some of the red, a big spoonful, get it down to the bottom as best you can. Undo the cuff and then fold it over and roll and push it down as you're going. I didn't get much in this one, but you don't need a lot. That's plenty for a bunch of cookies. So actually now we're gonna outline it just like we did the pink heart, but I'm gonna make a couple of subtle changes. Because a strawberry isn't really super pointy at the bottom like a heart is, and the top is a kind of a softer indent. So I'm gonna start over here, and again, I'm gonna touch down, let it attach to the cookie, and then I'm gonna squeeze, but I'm gonna actually make it more of a little U shape there. I didn't really make a perfect sharp point because I want it to be a little bit more natural, like a strawberry would be. And I'm gonna, at the bottom, what I'm gonna do is I'm not gonna go all the way to the point. I'm gonna curve it. So it really has more of that strawberry feel. If you want, you could also wiggle it a little so it's not so straight. I like to do that sometimes. But you can just, or keep it straight, and then when you get to the end, you can kind of try to seamlessly, you know, end it. And there you go. So that's gonna be my strawberry. So the next step, once you've outlined the cookie, is the flooding of the cookie. And What that is covering the surface of the cookie with as thin a layer of icing as you can, but still enough that it covers the whole cookie completely and, you know, so you don't see any of the surface of the cookie, in a nice smooth layer that flows as you lay it on. So I'm gonna add a little egg white, little by little, to get it to the consistency that I consider perfect for flooding. One thing I'm gonna do also is add a teeny drop of whitener. Again, not because I really wanna lighten it, but just because I want the quality of the icing to have that slightly opaque look. See how it falls off the spoon, and you'll get to know what's gonna work for you. So, I think that's pretty good. I'm gonna add like the teeny tiniest bit more, just to be sure. Okay. I'm gonna get everything off from the sides. Okay. I'm gonna take a slightly bigger brush. Again, I use a stiffer brush, not a soft brush, because I don't want it to give, because I'm really using the brush as a tool to push the icing around, not to really exactly paint with it. So again, you dip in, and you give it a swirl, so you see it would be dripping, and you'd get it on the table, and on your cookie, you want to spin the brush and get the icing off the brush. I'm going to do that a couple of times. When you get really experienced with this, you get to know exactly how much, you know, to get on the cookie the first time around. That takes a little bit. So I also use my hand as a turntable. I've gotten used to that. You see, I'm just using my fingers to turn the cookie. So I'm just using the side of the brush to smooth out the icing. I'm gonna take a little more. I try to get as little icing as I possibly can on the cookie, because I just don't want a thick layer of icing. I want the taste of the icing without overkill. So I'm just spreading it to the edge, and again, I'm covering the edge while I'm spreading the icing, because I don't want it to show, like, here's the edge and here's the flooded part. I want it to be one sort of seamless piece. Okay, so I pretty much covered the icing, the cookie. I'm gonna go back and spread it flat. Once you've pretty much painted an area, you can't go back to it. You can go back to it within, you know, seconds of doing it, but you can't decide, oh, a minute later, I think I'll go back and smooth that area, because it'll have crusted over and you'll mess it up. So just going over it, popping any big bubbles that I see with the brush, and just checking to see that I've covered the lines if possible. That looks pretty good. And that's now a flooded cookie, ready for its leaves and little yellow seeds. We're just gonna let it dry for at least, you know, half an hour. So now we've got the strawberry cookie painted red and all nice and dry. And we're gonna take it a step further than we took the heart cookie, where we stopped at this point. We just added a few decorations. But for the strawberry, we're gonna actually add another technique, which is adding a second layer for the leaves right on top of the strawberry. So it kind of will give it a slightly three-dimensional layered look, which is really cool. So first we're gonna make the green icing for the strawberry leaves. We're not gonna need as much as we did with the red and pink, because we're just outlining and painting in the leaves. So stop there. I'm gonna start with a little bit of forest green and see what that does. You can also use leaf green, probably any green will. Once you learn this technique, you can do such complicated cookies so simply. It's just more about timing and more colors. But the technique is really not very complicated. Okay, I think I'm gonna add a little bit of the mint green to get this a little brighter. And again, stir it, get it all up from the bottom. You can always just use one green, like a leaf green or mint green, but sometimes it's fun to mix two different colors together so you can get a unique color that you might not see anywhere. So we're gonna thin it out a bit again for the piping icing. This is the one that you wanna get sort of similar to toothpaste, so that when you squeeze it through the tip, it's gonna be thick enough to hold its shape, not so thick that it's hard to squeeze and it will dry out, and not so thin that it will like run all over and not hold its, you know, not do what you want it to do. I'm just gonna add a teeny more bit of mint to get it a little darker. Okay. I think I'm gonna stick with that, and I'll tell you why. Because it's a touch tighter than the last lining icing I used, but when you're lining on top of a cookie that's already been iced, you can use a tighter line. Okay, so let's load this into the piping bag. And I think actually this time I'm gonna, all right, we'll take a number 1.5 again. A 1.5 is gonna give you a fatter line, and a 1 is gonna give you a thinner line. And they're kind of interchangeable, but if you want a nice fine line, you're gonna use a number 1. But here I'm sticking with the 1.5, all right? So take a spoonful. Get it off the spoon. Fold it over and then down. And the nice thing about the plastic bags is, well, for one thing, you can see the color compared to, say, a parchment bag, which I also like, but you can always see what color easily, and these will actually keep overnight really well because the plastic keeps the, you know, the air out and the moisture in. We're gonna line the leaves. You know, what you can do if you're not sure like where the leaves should be, you can, you know, look at a picture of a strawberry or just use your imagination. I'm gonna give it 3 leaves, and I'm gonna, you're trying to, in a certain kind of way, disguise the fact that it's a heart and just pretend it's a strawberry. So I'm gonna put maybe 1 leaf up there. I'm gonna make another leaf here. And then I'll make a 3rd leaf. I'm trying to really go to the edge so we don't see the red edge. Okay, and I did the same technique as I did before. You know, just touching down, letting the icing fall, releasing when I needed to let go, and there you go. So those are the leaves, and now what you're gonna do is fill this in. Same concept as before when you painted in the hearts, you're gonna flood the leaves. Just a much smaller area, so it's actually easier, and kind of very satisfying to watch those leaves get filled in. Now this is gonna be just like we did before. Thin it out to flooding consistency. That would be still a little too thick. See, it's just hardly falling off the spoon. And I'm actually gonna add a teeny drop of whitener again because I kind of wanna get it a little bit lighter than the line so that when we re-outline it, that line actually will make a nice kind of graphic edge. I think that's kind of good. Also, you know, you want to be sure you're going to cover the red, and because the whitener gives it sort of opacity, you know, keeps the red from showing through. Lightened it just a touch. I think that's kind of good. Okay. So I'll grab now maybe a slightly smaller brush. I'll use this brush because the bigger brush would make it a little more difficult to use in that small space. You want to be a little bit more careful this time about putting too much on. This time I'm actually not going to smash the icing onto the cookie. I'm just going to let it fall off the brush this time. And so I'm just going to let my lines do all the work. I'm just going to move the icing around. It's kind of just like magic, really. They just fill in the spaces. It's almost hard to make a mistake because it's like a coloring book. And I'm gonna try to cover the lines. Even though I'm going to re-outline this, I still wanna cover the lines. I just think it looks much nicer in the end. Okay, so that's that. It's smoothed right in there. Looks really clean and pretty. We actually added another level of layering because we've added the strawberry leaves on top of the layer of strawberry red. And that gives you so many more options. can take you so much farther with cookie decorating. So the next step on this is going to be to add the seeds of the strawberry. So we're going to make a little bit of, it's really like a very pale yellow. Make a little bit of pale yellow, and not too much. And I know this icing seems really stiff, but it's the best to start with stiff because then you can really make anything you want. You're not stuck with one consistency of icing. So I add a touch of yellow. Yellow gets bright pretty quickly. And I know I want to add whitener because of that whole opaque thing. So put that in and see what happens. Once you get familiar with the, again, with the colors, you'll just instinctively know what to grab for and how much to squeeze. These gel food colors are available at any cake supply store online. They're really easy to find, and you can get tiny little bottles, or these are the medium-sized bottles, and they come in a huge array of really cool colors. I'm going to make this a teeny bit lighter for the seeds because I want them to read as sort of a whitish yellow. And the whitener is actually going to serve to thin out the icing a little bit, but just to let you know, you never want to really use whitener as a thinner because actually it'll never dry. So just a little bit. Okay. So now that, of course, is way too stiff for the seeds to come through the tips, I'm going to thin this out to pretty much the consistency that we've been using for the outlining. And it's nice that the cookie is hard right now because you're going to squeeze these seeds out of the tip and kind of want to really put your pastry tube tip firmly against the cookie. All right, that looks perfect. Here I'm using, again, a 1.5. I'm going to just poke it down with the end of a brush. Yep. Get it secure in there. If it's not really tight in there, you can have icing oozing through, and that gets messy. So we'll load this one up. I mean, this is going to really give it the character. The technique here is going to be kind of like when we added the dots to the pink heart. Just adding a decoration to a hard cookie. And then a little more. Okay, just get it down there. Test it out to make sure there's no clogs. Okay. So you're not going to use a brush. Obviously, we're just going to use the tip filled with this yellow to make the seeds. And we're going to give them a little bit of, give them, not just put them straight, because we want to keep the volumetric, like the rounded feel of the strawberry. And we want them to have that look of seeds, which is usually, thicker at one end and thinner at the other. So we're just going to squeeze and then pull. Squeeze and then let the, get rid of, the, you know, lighten up on the squeeze. Squeeze and pull down. Squeeze and pull down, squeeze and pull down. Just say you make one that gets out of control or you decide you don't like the shape of it. Use a piece of paper with a straight edge and just use it as a little scoop. Take it right off and keep going. I mean, it wouldn't be a strawberry without all the seeds, so it really adds to the look. And it's so easy. You're just touching down, squeezing, pulling the tip down, and easing up on the pressure. So it's squeeze, pull, let it up. Squeeze, pull, stop squeezing. Squeeze, pull, stop squeezing. Okay. And you see how it gives it like the real, almost makes it seem, rounded. Okay, so I think that's good. We're going to now line the leaves, which is taking it a little bit, again, farther than the first cookie, because the first cookie, we didn't re-outline anything. Here we're going to re-outline the leaves to give them a little bit of pop. And it's going to also differentiate between among the three leaves. So we're going to touch down, let it attach, and then go right around the edge of the leaf. And this line is just a tiny bit darker than the interior part of the leaf, but even if it were exactly the same, it's just the texture and the three-dimensionality that will let you see it. So again, we're gonna go right around the edge, kind of touch down there to make that point. And I'm letting it fall from above because that's allowing me to really follow the edge of that leaf. And again, I'm gonna now we'll do the third leaf. You know, another thing is I always like to go, I'm a right-handed person, so I like to go usually left to right and top to bottom. It's just easier because the icing is flowing out of the tube sort of naturally. If I tried to go right to left, I could probably do it, but it would fall out it would just be a little harder to control the way the icing came out of the tip. So there you go, you've got your three leaves, you've got your seeds. We could do one more thing, which you also, if you wanted to take it a tiny little quick step further and kind of pull the whole thing together, you could re-outline the strawberry, and that would, which we didn't do in the first cookie, so it's another little added dimension. And I'll show you how to do that. We're just gonna take the red that we used to initially outline the strawberry, and we're gonna start right here, and I'm gonna re-outline the strawberry. It's just gonna define it a tiny bit more. I'm gonna go over that rounded bottom that makes it different from the heart and a little bit more like a strawberry. And I am going to stop there. And so that really kind of gives a little more punch and a little more, you know, illustrative quality. We've got a really cute strawberry. I'm gonna put this aside to let it dry. And I'm gonna show you yet another really even more advanced technique you can do with the same shape cookie. So we started with the heart cookie, which was fairly simple, just outlining and flooding, and then a little bit of decoration. Then we moved on to the strawberry, which had another level of layering and a little bit more advanced. And now I'm going to show you one that's even more complicated, but actually no more difficult once you've got the techniques down. And it's going to be a fish from the same heart cutter. So we're gonna turn it this time. We're not gonna use it with the point down. We're gonna put the point to the left and start to turn it into a fish. So I think we're gonna make the body of the fish pretty blue, and we'll make the fins green and add some yellow stripes. So let's make the blue for the fish. And we're gonna, same as before, get some royal icing in the bowl. You know, you can make your fish all different colors, which, since fish are so colorful. And the other fun thing I've done with the heart cutter is when I've turned it into a fish, you can find, sometimes heart cutters come in concentric sizes, and then you can have like a school of fish. And that's really fun. Okay, so the blue gets dark pretty quickly. We're gonna start with just a teeny drop. And stir that in. We want to keep it sort of a light, bright blue, nothing too dark and heavy. Almost like, you know, fish are so bright. I kind of like this. Let's add a little bit of whitener to see what happens. I'm going to add like two or three drops. And a teeny tiny bit more blue. I think that's a really pretty color, but it looks a little bit too close to the water, so one more little drop. You know, if you ever want to just add the tiny touch of a color, say you want to make a light gray, you have to be careful because black food coloring gets dark really fast, so I like to squeeze out a little bit on a plate or the table or piece of paper and add the color with a toothpick from the little drop you've squeezed out. But for this, I didn't need to do that, so let's thin it out a little bit for lining, the one that you want to get to be a little bit like toothpaste. Oh, I just had another thought. You know, I think I'm actually gonna, because I want to outline the fish in blue in the end, I want to re-outline it. I'm gonna make this a little darker, and then I'll lighten up the body of the fish so that I don't have to make two different colors. So I think that's gonna work well. I'm gonna make it a little darker than I planned. Okay, again, this would be okay if we were just going on top of a layer of icing, but since we're starting on a plain cookie, I'm gonna make it a little looser so it'll stick. Teeniest bit more. That's like just about two drops more. If you ever make it too loose by accident, you can always add either a little bit of confectioner's sugar or a little bit of the very thick icing from the main mixing bowl. Okay, there we go. So put that into the bag. And I think I'll stick with the 1.5 tip. Get it, if you're having trouble, oh, there we go. Pull it taut like that so icing doesn't come through. And a big scoop. And we'll just scoop that down to the bottom. So when we make the fish, we're actually going to use a technique that I haven't shown you yet. We're going to have two layers of flooded icing next to each other, two separate colors. So right now we'll make the body of the fish. So I'm going to start over here where the mouth of the fish is. And I'm going to seeming like I'm just outlining the cookie, but I'm going to cut it off right here where the fin will be. And I'm going to just kind of inventing what I think the body of the fish would look like, making sure I leave room for the fins. And there you go. So that's all you need to do right now. We're not even going to flood it yet. We're going to first put the fins on. So I've outlined the body of the fish in a pretty electric kind of blue, and now we're going to make a pretty green for the fin. We'll use the mint green, because that's kind of bright and pretty. And add two drops of that. And I can tell we want to lighten that up a tiny bit, so add a tiny bit of whitener. There's so many kinds of greens. There's leaf green, electric green, forest green. And they're all a little bit different, but you can use them interchangeably, and you can always add blue to it to change the color, or if you want to dull it down, you can add a little red. I'm actually going to go a little bit darker, because again, we're going to use it for an outline and to fill in. Okay, that looks good. Okay, thin it out to flooding, lining consistency, piping consistency. The toothpaste one. Another thing I sometimes do if I think I've gone a little too far with the thinning is there's always a bunch of thicker stuff left in the bowl of the spoon. So I sometimes just take my finger and get that stuff out, because and the stuff from the back, it acts to thicken it a little. So we'll load up a tube with the green. And I'm probably going to lighten that up when I go to do the flooding, but for right now, it's great. Grab a tip. Make sure, yep. I want to make sure you put enough in the bag, but still leave enough for flooding the cookie. Get it down to the bottom. just keep folding and folding till it seems really secure. And then I'm just shaking it to make sure the tip is all the way down there. Let's try it out. Yep, we're good. So now I'm going to add the fins, the top and bottom fin and the back fin. So I'm just going to start right here. Just let the icing drop right where I wanted it to start, right touching the blue. And I'm going to just line the edge of the cookie and stop about there. And you can see another thing that's different about this cookie is we're really not using the whole cookie. We're leaving parts of it bare and just decorating the parts that we need to make it look like a fish. And then we'll do the one at the bottom. And the reason I'm stopping there and then going this way is, I remember I said I like to go left to right. If I tried to go right to left, the icing would be falling out of the tube and against it, against the grain sort of. So I went right, left to right, and I'm gonna go left to right again. And then I'm gonna add a little tail. I mean, I just kind of got the idea of what a fish looked like from looking at a couple of pictures. And then when we realized it fit perfectly into the heart shape, we knew we had a good combination. So there you go. Now the blue has actually set up nicely enough by now that I'm going to flood it with a same color blue. I'm actually going to lighten it up. So I've got a little lighter, and I need to thin it out to flooding consistency. Now I'm wondering if I add a little too much, I'm just going to pour a little bit. It didn't get colored. You could also pour it into the sink. But I do that all the time. Sometimes I just pour it into the garbage pail. A little too thick still. You can see how it's not flowing. So we'll do it again. Some people use water to thin it out, but I've done a little test and I kind of like the egg white better. I find it dries a little quicker, a little harder, and a little bit shinier. I prefer it. Almost there. I'm going to give it a little more. Okay, I like that. I'll grab a kind of a medium big brush. You know, the brushes, again, are pretty interchangeable. The bigger the brush, the more quickly you'll get the job done, but maybe a little bit harder to control. So pick it up carefully so you don't, you know, bump against one of the lines. And we're going to do the same thing we did before. Get a bunch on your brush, twirl your brush, and get it on the cookie. Repeat. Okay, we'll start with that. Again, I'm just going to spread it with the side of my brush. And you can see how quickly the line actually set up. All right, now, don't like take this stuff and try to get it over there, because you'll just have to go back and repaint the area that you took the paint from, the icing from. So always go back for a little more. And sometimes I just go like this over the surface to pop air bubbles to smooth it out. And it just, I never get tired of watching this happen, the way the icing just kind of magically fills in the space. It's very satisfying. So that looks pretty good. It's spread evenly and it looks nice and smooth. And now we're ready to paint in the fins. Grab the green. Again, I'm going to lighten up the green because I liked it for the line, but I want it a little brighter and lighter. So add a little bit of whitener. If for any reason you didn't have whitener, you could always just add icing. But it would almost be better to start with white icing and then add this to the white icing, because if you Sometimes you try to add icing to the dark color, and it takes so long to lighten it, then you end up with massive amounts of icing, more than you need. But actually, I really like that color. It's just a little lighter and brighter. So now I'm going to thin it out with the egg white. And that's really why I have the egg white in a bowl. If you try to pour from the container, you have a really good chance of pouring in too much. This is easier to control. It's almost there. This is like a drop more. Okay. Of course, if you start to paint the green and you find it's not flowing, you can always, you know, readjust the consistency of your icing, which is why I actually like having it in bowls. You can, you know, change it constantly. Okay, we'll try that. It might be a little thick. Okay, so I'm going to take a pretty small brush because I have tiny little corners to get in. So pick, once you get really a little more confident with the brushes, you can use a big brush to get in there, but I'm going to show you how to do it with the smaller one. Again, you get some icing on there, and you go to the tip. I'm just kind of like nudging it in there. So there, it got in. And that green line is helping you keep it from going over the edge. Okay, so that's one fin. I think I'm going to thin it. It's really good, but I'm going to thin it out just a touch more to make it a little easier. You can also, when you're doing something that small, an area that small, you don't have to always hold the cookie. I'm going to show you with the next fin how you can actually just leave the cookie where it is and paint it there. Just another technique. All right, that's a little better. So I'm just going to leave it there, and okay, now that fin is filled in. Yeah, that's flowing a little better. You can really always, you know that you can readjust the consistency of your icing when it's in the bowl to you know, whatever feels good to you. And you see it's really just pushing that icing around, just nudging it and just getting it nice and smooth. And you know, these lines, this sort of separations between the blue and the green, will disappear later when we add final lines. So those colors look really pretty together. Okay, so now we're going to keep going on the little fish. I'm going to add some stripes, an area for his mouth, his eye, some stripes on his fins. So first we'll put a little yellow stripe on his body. Nice thin one. I'm going to give him a longer stripe. So he's like really colorful, tropical, pretty fish. Okay, so I think it's nice to give him a little accent around his mouth area. And a nice big eye. And we're gonna be filling in all these areas with icing. Okay, now for the stripes on his fins. This is just a little darker version of that same green. I'm just gonna try to let it fall right on the edge there. I'll add a couple more stripes to his fins. Okay, one more line to the fin, and then I'll do the same thing on the bottom. I'm going to outline it. That with the blue, when we re-outline the blue. So we'll give it a few lines here, like his fin. Then we'll outline the I'm not covering that area or that area, because we'll do that with the blue when we re-outline the blue. So we'll give it a few lines here, like wrist fin. Then we'll outline the tail. Is that what it's called? I'm not sure, but I think so. So when you outline it, it kind of like frames it, makes it pop. I'm always like, should we outline it? Because I like the cookies at every stage. Like not outlined is sort of beautiful, but once you, we always end up outlining because it just kind of just makes things all punchy and crisp and nice. So I'm just giving a little detail to the tail fin and there. Okay, so now we will paint in the yellow areas. I'm actually gonna paint in the nose part and the eye with this super pale yellow. And then I'm gonna brighten it up a tiny bit for the stripes. So I'm mixing the yellow first for the nose and the eye. And yellow, of all the colors, to me, can be the most translucent, especially when you're putting them on top of a brighter color, putting yellow on top of a brighter color. So I always, always, always add whitener. And that keeps the helps keep the bottom color from sort of showing through. It lets the yellow cover really well. Okay, that seems great. So I'm just covering two tiny little spaces. So I'm gonna take a small brush here. And I'm not gonna pick the cookie up because I wanna be able to steady my hand going in there. But I'm just gonna, this time I'm just gonna grab a little icing and blob it in. Just, it's a little bit different than the other techniques I showed you. You're not, you're just kind of dropping it in and letting it fill the space. And then the same with the eye. I'm just kind of being careful. My brush is really just at the top surface of the icing. It's nowhere near the surface of the cookie. It really feels so nice to do it. Okay, so that's his big bulging eye. Now I'm gonna brighten up the yellow just sort of to distinguish it from the other parts of the cookie and make it a little more fun and bright, so. Again, another nice thing about having the colors in a bowl, you can play with the color. You can do, you know, yellow stripes, and then you can add, you know, red to this and have orange stripes. I just like to be able to really play around with the different cookies. Okay, so that seems pretty good. I'm gonna use the same brush because I'm painting this narrow space. And I'm just going to, I'm just gonna like blob it in like that and then push it around. Just drop it in like that and then go back and spread it through. And you get this stripe that everybody's always saying, you know, it's so neat, but it's really all in the technique. You just see a couple of lines, a little icing to fill it in, and totally easy. So we'll go down to the bottom. And I use one hand to steady the other because it just helps a lot. Okay, so that's a one stripe. I'll just get a little farther down and then the other stripe. Drop more. Okay, cool. I love that. Okay, so the next thing I'm gonna do while these parts are setting up is outline the cookie in blue, just to, again, pull it all together. Oh, and then I'll go back and add the fin on the side. So I'm gonna start here. And I'm trying to let this line fall like in between where the green and the blue is. Whenever I get to a green area, I'm trying to fill, if there is a gap between the two areas, I'm trying to let the blue fall right into that gap. Now, I know I said I don't go right to left, but I just started, so I'm gonna keep going. It's doable, it's just a little harder. I'm gonna go around the tip of his nose area. And then I'm gonna try to seamlessly do that. Okay. And then just for fun, I'm gonna define that and okay. Now you could stop here, he looks great. But just for the heck of it, I'm gonna add a little fin on the side. And I'm gonna make that, you could do any color, but I'll make it green. So you're gonna line it, just go right on top of that stripe. Okay, and while that's setting up for just a couple of seconds, I'm gonna give him kind of a dark green eye. Now this eye area is still a little wet, but it'll be nice because the eyeball will just kind of sink in and look really cool. Here you go. And I'm gonna get the, oops, green. I'm gonna add just a touch more whitener, just maybe to differentiate it a little bit. Okay. So I'll take this brush that we were using before for the green. So now I'm gonna fill in the fin area, and I'm just gonna let it fall in there because there's that stripe that's behind it. I want it to just fall all around that stripe because we're gonna be covering that stripe. You're gonna see a little bump, but you really won't notice it. So I'm filling my brush up with green and just gonna let it gently, because this is still a little bit wet, gently let it fall into that space. So you see, you can really get a cookie done in one step if you want to. Okay. All right, I'm being gentle because I don't want to move that line. There you go. So I'm just gonna give the guy a little, you see I never stop. I'm gonna give him a little blue mouth and then we'll outline that fin and then I think we'll be done. Because he needs to have a little expression. And we'll re-outline the fin. I could re-outline the yellow stripes, but I actually think I'm going to leave it the way it is because it's like more a part of the fish's body. I'll just re-outline the fin here. And there you go, he's done. We've added multiple layers to the fish and he looks great. We're gonna set him aside for half an hour or even overnight to dry. So we finished our three cookies. We started with the plain heart, all from this cutter. And it's the simplest one. We use the techniques of lining the outer edge of the cookie and flooding it with royal icing. And then we added a little bit of simple decoration. Then we moved on to the strawberry, which is a little bit more difficult because we added another layer. We lined and piped the leaves on top of the strawberry. And then finally the fish, we turned the heart on its side and found that we could see a fish in it. So this involves a little bit more drawing because we weren't just simply outlining the shape of the cookie, we were outlining the body of the fish separately and the fins of the fish and then leaving part of the cookie unlined. And we had to flood those areas separately. Then we added another level where we added the stripes and then re-outlined them all separately. So that's a little bit more complicated, but really no harder because it's the same basic techniques we started with. And you don't have to stick to these particular designs. We've got a whole bunch of different things we've done with the hearts. We've made all kinds of patterns. You can really do whatever you want once you gain the confidence with the icing. You can really have fun with it. And once your cookies are done, you're probably gonna wanna figure out how you can keep them until you either give them away or use them at a party. And they'll keep a good couple of weeks in an airtight container at room temperature. I like to store them with wax paper or parchment paper in between the layers. But my favorite way of keeping them longer term, like even up to 2 months, is taking each cookie individually and putting it in a little cello bag or even a Ziploc bag. Just slide it right into the bag. Maybe tape the back, put it in the freezer. When you take it out of the freezer, just keep it in the bag because it might want to sweat. And then any condensation that happens will happen on the outside of the bag, not on the cookie. And I've done this, you know, a number of times and it works great. So if you master these tips and techniques, there's no limit to what you can do if you let yourself get a little bit creative with some cookies and frosting.